Hi folks, and thanks for joining us for another one of these pop-up webinars. My name is Sebastian Bleek, and in a little bit we're going to be joined by Nicholas Vanderwall, founder of Astute Graphics, and some of the Astute Graphics team members back in Herefordshire. All right, so today we're going to be talking about MirrorMe. That's actually our product of the month this month, so if you head over to astutegraphics.com, you could actually get a little bit of a discount on MirrorMe, and you're also going to find some goodies. We're going to have stuff like this webinar up there and other videos and some extra tutorials. So go ahead and check that out. And also, remember, if you buy like three or more of our plugins at one time, you're going to get a savings on that anyway. So go ahead and just triple up on that. All right, cool. So today what we're doing is we're actually going to work on two projects. First thing is I'm going to show you guys how to set up a MirrorMe project. So we're going to have a symmetrical design. We're going to vectorize it, only drawing half of it. MirrorMe is going to take care of the rest of the work for us. We're going to finish off that project, then move on into the future, work on a different project where we're actually going to be upcycling that artwork that we already spent a bunch of time working on. So let's get right in it. It'll make more sense once I start getting into it. All right, cool. So this is actually based off of a tutorial that Iroslav wrote a while back. So right here in this situation, what's going on, my buddy Iroslav over in the UK, in the Ukraine, sent me this pencil drawing that we have set up here. All right, so this is just a pixel-based image. Because it was on my clipboard, it's just a little TIFF right there. It's showing me over here at the top. Now, a couple things about this guy before we get into MirrorMe. We want to do a little bit of setup. Now, I want to actually use this as a template so that I could trace over this using my favorite drawing tools. All right, so one thing that I'm noticing right away is even though my pixels are nice and straight, the drawing is a little bit crooked. If I zoom in a little bit further, you'll kind of notice that the butterfly is leaning a little bit towards 1 o'clock right there. All right, so before we get into MirrorMe, I'm going to walk you through some things using Subscribe. That's a free plugin. We'll throw a link in the comments in a little bit for that. Now, the tool I'm going to be using throughout the demo is this guy over here in the tools panel. It's the Orient tool. It's part of Subscribe. So I figured I'd take some time and show you how this guy actually works. So when you see it later, it won't throw you off. All right, so I see these little center points right here, and that's going to help me straighten this guy out. So one way to work with this is if I click right here once, and then come over here and click again, you want to make sure that your artwork is selected, and that's what I see over here on the left. Now I get these cool annotations, and when I hover over them, I get these arrows. So I could use this one, whichever one, the top one or the bottom one. I'm going to use the top one. Now that I'm hovering over it, I could click and drag, and now I'm starting to rotate that object around. And if I hold down the shift key, it's actually going to constrain that and keep it nice and straight for me. So if I back out, check this out. My butterfly is nice and straight, and that's what I need for when I bring in MirrorMe, except for that my pixels are a little bit crooked. You notice I get this little jagged edge going on here. That's fine. For this workflow, this is exactly what I need. But let's say the roles were reversed. Let's say you wanted your pixels to be straight and you weren't really too worried about the image or not. Well, the way to get this straightened out really quick is while you have it selected, you want to hold down the Alt or Option key and then just double click on it. All right, so it's going to straighten it out for you. Keep in mind, pixels are for squares. So Subscribe, all it's doing is it's getting that horizontal and vertical information and just straightening everything up. So now we got this guy nice and straight. All right, so let's zoom in on this guy a little bit. All right, so I'm going to do that again. Earlier what I did, I did a click and then another click. This time what I'm going to do is a click and a drag. So whichever way you want to work with it, you can go ahead and do that. Now that I got my annotation set up, I come over here, click and drag, move this guy around, hold down the shift key, and then release. All right, when I zoom out, I got this guy nice and ready to go. Okay, let's head over to the right side of my screen, and we're going to play around with the layers panel a little bit. Since this is going to be my template, I want to dim it down a little bit, and I want to make sure that I don't damage it by playing around, so I want to lock everything down. Well, if I double-click on that layer, it's going to give me access to the layer options. I'm going to click on template, and that's going to dim out all these options, but it's going to wake this guy up right here. Dim images to about 50%. All right, so keep an eye on my image. If I click OK, you see, it's just dropped the opacity down about 50%. It deselected it and it's locked it down so I can't make any changes to it by accident and mess things up. All right, if you look over here in the layers panel, you see it's locked down and the text right here is kind of italicized to let you know that it's turned into a template. You could always come in here, double click on it and change the value. 50% is what it's set to by default. But I know my buddy Carlos, he's not in here today, but he likes playing around with MirrorMe a lot, and he usually drops this down to about 25%. So right here, it's really dim, but I want to make sure you guys can see it online, so I'm going to bring this guy back up to about, let's say, 40% and call it a compromise. All right, cool. Remember, you want to actually activate the layer above so you can start drawing because this one's locked down over here in the layers panel on the right. So back over here to the artboard. I'm taking a look at my artwork right here. Now I want to start setting up that mirroring access with MirrorMe. So To bring up the MirrorMe panel, you want to come over here to the window menu, scroll down until you find MirrorMe, and then bring up the MirrorMe panel. All right, so this is going to give you all the controls for that tool right in here. Now, to activate the tool, come over here to the left. You're going to find the Tools panel. Now, the little icon right here looks like a butterfly. That's MirrorMe. Click on it to activate it. Now, when I come into my document, things start getting a little crazy. So this used to throw me off in the beginning, and I know for new users it does as well. So what's actually going on here is we have five axes going on. If you take a look at my MirrorMe panel, right in here is showing five axes. I'm going to actually click the decrement button to reduce the number of axes, but I also can use my open and close brackets to reduce or increase the number of axes. Now, the open and close brackets that I'm talking about are the ones just to the right of the P key on it's on my keyboard. I'm using an American MacBook Pro. All right, so I'm going to back off until I just have a single axis here. So that looks pretty cool. Now, it's kind of leaning off to the side. Don't worry about that too much. We'll fix that in a bit. All right, I'm going to zoom in on my image because I want to be a little bit more precise. All right, now see this little intersection right here? That's going to be the midpoint of my drawing. So I'm going to click there once. Now I get this annotation. I got this axis kind of hanging out to the side right here. So what's actually going on? Well, the annotations right here is going to help you work with MirrorMe. So this first option is actually dimmed out, so you don't have access to that. The next one is apply to layer, and the little hint right there, persistent, that's going to let you know that we're just going to leave it on and we're going to be vectorizing the whole time. Right here, cancel is to back out of it, but I really don't use that one that much because you could always come back in here and start editing. So I'll show you what I mean. You come in here and just click and drag to reposition this guy. And if you needed to, you could always reposition the center point right in here. All right, so I'm going to leave this right there, click and drag, and then hold down the shift key to keep it nice and straight. Now I got this thing split right down the middle. Now, if you take a look at these little arrows, the arrows are pointing towards the right because what I want to do is draw on the right. These little arrows kind of give me a hint that this is the area I could draw on. Now, if you notice on the left, it has like a little bit of an overlay. That's what this guy is right here. That overlay is where MirrorMe is going to be mirroring my new vectors. So that's pretty much how I read this. If it's if I have a little bit of a block going on right here, this little white area, that's where I'm going to be mirroring. And these arrows are saying, draw over here, draw over here to the right. You could always make those changes over here. Check this out. The angle is set to 270, but if I enter in a new value, you see that axis starts spinning around. All right, so I'm going to leave it at 270. Tab it over. And I want to apply to the layer persistent. So I click on that. And there you go. So now we're ready to rock. What I could do now is bring up one of my favorite drawing tools. In this situation, it's going to be the Inkscribe tool. Click on it to activate it. And I'm going to go through some keyboard shortcuts on the appearance. I'm going to hit the D key to give it the default appearance, Shift X to swap those guys out, and then the slash key to get rid of the stroke. X key is going to activate the fill. If you want me to go over those again later on during the Q&A, just let me know. All right, cool. So I'm going to zoom in on this guy a little bit, and I'm going to get started right over here where this dude's head is at. All right, so I'm going to click just to the left of the axes. When I click there, MirrorMe moves that anchor point over for me. Let me just bring this guy up a little bit. And I notice it's a smooth point. I'm going to double click on that guy. And so right now I'm drawing out straight segments and corner points. All right, if you need to move this guy around, you could always do that just by doing this. Clicking and dragging. I'll click right here, come back down over here to the bottom, click again, and then MirrorMe just pushes that anchor point over towards the right for me. All right, so double click on this dude. And that's going to turn into a smooth point. And I'm just going to start pulling these pieces out. And you could use any tool you want. I just wanted to show you a little bit of workflow with Inkscribe. I'm coming in here and just playing around with these guys. Let's see. I'm going to smooth this dude up a little bit. There we go. There you go. So any of your drawing tools would work out just fine in here. All right. So let me zoom out a little bit. I'm going to keep playing around with Inkscribe just a little bit. A lot of people always ask me just what the workflow is when you're using MirrorMe and like Inkscribe, or if you don't have Inkscribe and you're using the pen tool, you would do a similar workflow. All right, so I'm going to grab the Inkscribe tool again, come back over here. I'm going to click once right here. I actually want these guys to start off as corner points, so just double click on it. Good to go. Laying out these corner points. I got that fill activated. Now what's happening is I can't see my template. All right, so what I usually do in my workflow, you don't have to do this, but this is how I do it. I'm going to hit Command Y on my keyboard. And that's going to get rid of the appearance. Now I'm just looking at the structure of my artwork. But check this out. That's why I also have my navigator up. Now I know a lot of people don't use navigator. It's kind of an old school panel, but I find it very useful. Over here, it showed me both of my artboards, and I could see the mirroring happening right here. So this little red square is where my view is currently. So inside that red square is what I'm drawing. But check this out. It's showing me what I'm mirroring as well. So I could keep an eye on my appearance over here on the right. And over here on the left, I'm just taking care of my structure. All right, so I'll keep on with my little workflow here. All right, so I'll keep this going, just laying down anchor points, clicking and dragging, moving these guys around. Now, the reason I like working with InkScribe over the pen tool, even though I used to love the pen tool, is all I'm doing is clicking and dragging. I'm not changing any tools. I'm not using any modifiers. I got my one hand tied behind my back at the moment. So I'm using a trackpad on my MacBook Pro. I'm just moving these pads around where I want them. So it gives me a lot of control over that. So check that out. Whatever I draw over here on the right is mirroring over here on the left. So let me do it from a distance so you could actually see it a little while it's actually happening. I'm going to come down here to the bottom. There's a really basic shape here. I could do it from while I'm zoomed out. All right, so click, click, come over here to the right, click. I actually got smart guides on. Let me turn those off. Command U to turn those off. All right, so I'll click right over here. Now, take a look over there on the left. You can start seeing those two segments and those three anchor points laid out. Now, I'm going to come over here and lay down the last segment. I'm going to go ahead and click, and you see it's closed off right over there. Next, what I'm going to do is zoom in on this piece and just start making my edits. Well, it wasn't as precise because I was zoomed all the way out. So here we go. Let me fix this so that Nick doesn't get upset by that. Here we go. All right, cool. So let me round these pieces off. I want this to be a little bit smoother. Here we go. This guy could come in a little bit, just look a little bit more organic. Now, when I zoom out, MirrorMe already took care of the work for me, so I'm good to go. All right, so let's pretend I continued on this and finished drawing this whole thing out. I'm going to hit Command Y. Now you can see the appearance of the stuff we're drawing. Once we've finished drawing out this whole section of the butterfly right here, if you want to just finish it off, the easiest way to do it is just come over here to the MirrorMe panel. See this big button right here that says Remove Axes? When you click on it, it'll remove the axes for you, and it's no longer mirroring. So when I zoom in on this shape right here, even though I was drawing on the right side, check this out. It already took care of the pathfindering for me, and if I had a complex appearance on there, it would actually retain that for me as well. Now, you're probably noticing that these guys aren't all grouped together. All I have to do is grab them all together, Command-G, and now I have all these objects grouped up. Now, if you want to see what it looked like when it was finished, I'll come over here to the symbols. I already got one baked up for you. All right, so right here, I'm going to break the link so you can see all the little anchor points and stuff that went into doing this. So Irislav actually pulled out MirrorMe, sat there for a little bit, and inkscribed out this section, and MirrorMe took care of the site over here on the left. All right, so he was basically able to cut his time at least in half right in there, and he didn't have to spend any time trying to weld everything together. All right, so let me cut this guy out, switch over to that other blank artboard that I got set up over here. All right, so we're done with that project. This one right here, this we already turned it into the client. Client's happy. They sent me the check cleared, so I'm happy. Now, a couple days later, weeks, months, years, whatever it is. I mean, you spent time creating this design, so why let it die just there? I mean, the project's done, but that doesn't mean that the design has to be done as well. So let's bring this guy back and start creating some new designs out of it. That's why we're talking about upcycling. So we're gonna repurpose this design now using MirrorMe. So back over here on the left, we're gonna activate the MirrorMe tool once again. I'll come back into my document. We have that single axes. Remember, you could always come back over here into the MirrorMe panel, introduce some more axes, or you could use your open and close brackets on your keyboard and that'll bring in some more for you as well. All right, so let's start playing around with this guy. You could already see some really cool things happening. This is a very organic way to work. This isn't precision, this is playing around. This is where you guys have fun and just experiment, all right? So I'm gonna just click right there. I get my annotations, but look, this guy woke up. Apply to selection, all right? Earlier we were working with apply to layer persistent. I don't really use cancel too much. So right here, when I click on apply to selection, it already took care of the mirror for me. Now, again, when I first started using that feature, this threw me off. I'm like, is MirrorMe not done yet? What's going on? Why is this still going crazy? Well, what's actually happening is I've got some artwork selected and I have the MirrorMe tool activated. So MirrorMe is gonna mirror, it's gonna do its job. So what we need to do is actually just switch tools. So I'm gonna hit the V key. Now we got the selection tool, and if I deselect, there you go. We got this awesome artwork set up in seconds based off of some artwork that we created a long time ago. You know, we're playing pretend right now. All right, cool. So let's see, if you wanna straighten this guy out a little bit, this is again a little Carlos Garro workflow here. We're gonna be using Subscribe. So I got this guy right here. My artwork is selected at the moment. So I'm gonna come back into the tools panel and activate the orient tool. Now, what I'm doing here is I'm looking for some anchor points that are gonna make this thing nice and straight for me. So I'm looking at these guys right here. I want these two to be straight like 915. So let me come over here. I'm gonna click and drag right over here till I get to this anchor point and then release. Now I could just click and drag this guy around and I'll hold the shift key. There you go. It wasn't too much of a change, actually. Let me see. It actually looked pretty good like that. All right, so let me spin this dude around because I liked having the point up at the top. That looks a little bit better. All right, cool. Let me bring this guy down a little bit. All right, so now we have this small little piece of artwork right over here. We'll save that for a little bit. All right, I'm gonna paste this guy in here. Now, every time you do this, you're gonna get a different result. So let me walk you through this a couple more times. I'm gonna click on this little MirrorMe guy, come back in here. I wanna reduce the number of axes to get a different look. I'll click right around here. Now, you could always make changes to this. Look, I'm gonna come over here, see this little edge? I'm gonna grab that edge, click and drag. Now I'm getting more awesomer stuff happening. All right, cool. So let me just play around with this a little bit. That looks pretty cool. You could always grab the centerpiece right here and move the whole pie around if you need to. All right, kind of liking this little flower effect. Go ahead and release, apply that to the selection, change tools. There we go. So let's take a look. Is this guy straight? This one's actually a little bit more crooked. The first one wasn't too bad, but this one, I could see these points right here aren't really helping me out. All right, so I am going to turn on my smart guides. I'm going to hit Command U really quick because it'll let me know when I'm hovering over anchor point and I'll be more precise with this. All right, I'm going to come over here in the tools panel, grab the orient tool. You see this anchor point right here? All right, so I'm going to click on that guy once, come back over here to this anchor point, click on that guy. All right, so I get these little arrows. Everything looks like it's going great. If I click and drag, then I wonder why nothing's really happening. What's going on is I didn't select my artwork. So remember, guys, you got to select your artwork, let Illustrator and Subscribe know what it is you're actually trying to do. All right, so I'll come back over here, turn on the Orient tool again. This time I'm going to come over here over this anchor point, click and drag, and come right over here. So there's two different ways you could work on it. You could click on each destination, or you could click from your start point and then release at your end point. All right, I got these little arrows, click and drag, hold down the shift key. This guy's nice and straight. I'm going to back out. V key to bring up the selection tool, and let me see. There you go. That's the final look right there. It's a pretty cool looking design, and it looks completely unique when you compare it to the other one. So I'm going to bring this guy down a little bit and bring it off over here to the upper left. We can shrink this guy down a little bit more, but it doesn't need to be that big. All right, cool. Command V, paste this guy again. Last time, just so we could have three different pieces of artwork to play around with. All right, mirror me, come back in here. All right. I'm going to reduce the number of axes down to 4. I'm going to drop this guy off. All right, so that doesn't mean you're done. You could always continue to edit. So I'll bring this guy around this way. If you want to play around with the number of axes, you could do that right in here still. Don't worry about it. It's fully editable. Everything's dynamic. And then you grab this little centerpiece right here, click and drag it around. That looks pretty cool. I actually wanted a nice little square piece, so that happened pretty cool. All right, I'm going to click apply to selection. Nice little happy accident. Hit the V key. All right, now I'm going to straighten this guy out. I have my artwork selected this time. I'm gonna hit the Orient tool and let's zoom in right here somewhere in the middle. That'll help me out. All right, so I'm gonna click right here over that anchor point and click again over here. Now click and drag up, shift, release, back out of it. There we go, that looks sweet. So look, we got something kind of round. We got something that has like some points to it, almost like a flower, and we even got a little square design. So we had three completely unique looking pieces of artwork based off of something that we already finished. This was already a done project. We actually spent some time on it. So your time is valuable. Make sure you make some good use out of it. We want you guys to get some good ROI out of your time. All right, now we created this stuff using MirrorMe. What could we do with it? What could we make look really interesting with this? Well, I'm gonna grab this dude right here, click and drag, bring it over here into the swatches, and then just release. All right, so big wow. I made a little swatch right here and I could see a little preview of it. What I've actually done is I created a pattern right now. So I'm gonna come over here, grab my dynamic shapes tool. I'm gonna click and drag this guy out and then release. I got my fill activated. So back in the swatches panel, I'm gonna click on this little pattern and there you go. So that looks really cool already as is. But then I also get a lot of people to tell me that they're not really too happy with how the patterns look right out the box. Well, remember, you could always go in here and edit it. These are vectors. This is a vector editing software. So let's double click on this little thumbnail right here. Now we're entering into this little pattern options mode and we're just dealing with the pattern and we can make whatever changes we want in here. We have access to this like regular vectors. So if I wanted to scale this guy or spin it around, do whatever I want, it'll go ahead and update right in there. Now what I'm gonna do is switch from the tile type, brick by row, that looks all right. But I actually like brick by column a little bit better. All right, if I wanted to size the tile to art, sometimes I click on that, but I'm gonna leave that guy unchecked. Come in here, make sure this little guy is linked right here so I can maintain the width and height proportions. Now with my scroll wheel, I'm gonna make some changes. I like using the scroll wheel because it, I don't know, it just feels like it's happening in real time. It just looks cool. So here we go. I'm gonna bunch these guys in because sometimes I like when the patterns overlap each other, because then the patterns make patterns and there's patterns inside patterns. It's pretty cool. All right, so let me move this guy out of the way. I'll come over here now that I'm done. I'm gonna click on this button right here that says done. All right, clicking on it, there we go. So now I got this awesome pattern set up right in here. It's all vectors, so if I zoom in, crazy amount, it looks cool no matter what. All right, there we go. So that's a quick way to make some awesome patterns. Now, remember, these shapes are dynamic, so you could always come back in here, make whatever changes you need, and make some cool effects there. All right, so let me get rid of this dude. What else could we do? We got this guy right here in the middle. All right, what I want to do with this guy is click and drag and drop him off right over here into the brushes palette. All right, right here we got new brush options. I'm actually going to choose a pattern brush. Click OK. Now we're going into a little bit of workflow stuff. All right, in here, because I am working in the Creative Cloud, I have access to these auto-sliced corners. So Illustrator automatically generated this corner for me and decided that this was the coolest looking corner and already applied it there for me. So thank you, Illustrator. That's awesome. But if you take a look over here, I'm missing this corner. And so if I try to add it over here, I'm going to click on this drop down, and that awesome auto corner is missing. I have these auto center and auto in between, but they don't quite look right. So I'm going to choose one and then get bummed out because it doesn't look exactly like I want it. Well, we'll come back over here into this drop down menu. And for some reason, now we have access to the auto sliced one. So I'll click on that. I don't really know why it works that way, but that's how it works for me. If you guys have a little tip on that you want to share with me, go ahead and let me know in the comments. But that's my little workaround to get this corner cracking right over here. All right, so I'm going to click OK. We created a brush. All right, now what I want to do is grab my line segment tool over here in the tools panel. I'll click on this guy, click and drag. I got a little path laid out here. So I'm going to activate the stroke by hitting the X key over here in the brush panel. I'm going to click on that pattern brush we just created. And there you go. So we got this guy, and because it is on a path, I could grab my path scribe tool, come along here, and just make some changes. So I'm going to grab these little handles, start moving these guys around. And keep in mind, if you are on if you guys are on CS5 and above, you have access to the width tool. So you could always come over here and start making changes to these because it's pretty much just a stroke. You know, we made a brush out of it, so these are our brush strokes. So if you need to get some more realistic looks, you come over here and just start, you know, tapering off the edges and getting some really cool effects that way. All right, let me get rid of this guy and let's do it one more time. I'm gonna grab this beautiful little pattern right here. I'm gonna drop this guy off over here in the brushes panel. This is the important part. You don't want a scatter brush. You don't want an art brush. You want a pattern brush. So I'll click on that, click OK. We get this window. All right, I'm gonna choose a bad corner. Then I'm gonna choose the right corner. I'll click OK. All right, got this one set up. Line segment tool, click and drag. Activate this new brush that we created. There you go. All right, so Shift W if you wanna play around with the strokes again. There we go, and that's how we get that guy. All right. I'm gonna get rid of this because we could also apply that to some shapes. So I got this guy set up right in here. And there you go. So we created that awesome brush and we were able to apply it to pretty much any shape. We got some vectors in here. So go ahead and have fun with that. And there you have it, folks. So that's the demo we had prepared for you guys today. If you have to take off, we really appreciate you guys coming by and checking us out. Please keep an eye on our social media feed so you can find out when the next pop-up webinar is gonna be. And for those of you guys that were waiting around for Nick, I'm not sure if he's going to be here. I just got a text from George.